Welcome to another recording back FD Puffy. This time we are in FD's Dark World Templates. Template is shared by Icewitch. Thank you, Jim. Let's see what I made of it. I already use it multiple times, and as you can see, I put a very big structure in it. It is already way too heavy. One of my own fountain looks like it gives light, but it doesn't. X marks the spot. So start digging. A knight's building. As this piece comes out. We only have 60 items so far in this world. Oh, wrong button. Nope. We have 195 objects in it, and 4 kits, so this thing is not accurate. Or I have it somewhere else. Not on the other side. Alright, flight stick. Let's see if we can use it. Yep. That is the way we have to go. Fly a little bit backwards. That way I can enter my structure. Because it wants to render everything at the same time. So, here we created a little beginning. I did try to recreate one of the Oculus home screens, but I need way too much stuff to actually make it work. Okay. So that is why we are already at the end. Now, for you people to guess what I wanted to create in here. No, I want to make it small. Yeah. So, we have to fly a little bit. So here I created a water cascade. That is also in the original home setting of the Quest 2. But what I already told, I need way too much items. So just a few items in here and the cave owl, yeah. But I needed 10 times more, at least. Well, here is the thing I wanted to recreate. Well, of course, I don't have those dark buildings. So I have to make do with the kids I have. And here it ends already. And of course in the original one, if you look back, you only see one piece. So I make it a little bit bigger, so you have actually a room that you can use for something. Now we have to roam about. So we have to go down fast way. See if we can fly. Yes, a little bit. I already set my display at 1.4. Here I was starting to make that underground city. I just use my imagination. Something's upside down. And here my interpretation of the tower that you see. And somewhere I had to create a waterfall coming from the ceiling. But I didn't add that. So to emulate lights, I put those big fuckholes, candles in here. Oops, now it starts already to blimp a little bit, the screen. So I use the teleport. You can barely see this in the original. To no one need it. Here's another tower I created. Not usable, but a tower nevertheless. Well, the thing that makes the world so heavy is that big cave I created. Because if you oversize an item, it starts to get heavy. And that is what I did. So we have a vast underground cave system. Can go a lot further, but we are already way out. Somewhere around here, I wanted to create a mining facility. I guess that was somewhere around here. Nope. to find that other entrance of the cave. There's of course another way, but not while recording. Oh yeah, over here. Yeah. Here we go out. But here was the start I wanted to create. The dwarf mining facility. So as you can see, the cave goes on and on and on. And on and on. A nice space in here to use, but yep. I need a way more powerful headset. There we go again. Oh yes, it wants to render dots over there. So you can see there is a lot of space in here. It even takes a long time to go in a circle. So I really did it. Just oversizing Nico's basalt kit. Because that is what it is. Nico's basalt blocks, pillars, whatever. So where's the world now? I just was launched in outer space. And the world is so much bigger. And this one is asleep because here I had a very big screen, or still is. But I just disabled it. Oops. Now it don't want to render at all. So Nico, here's your basalt rock. Okay, well, thank you for watching.